Okay, so today we are going to be starting our energy unit. So this is a short unit. Should take us, probably we should be done definitely before Christmas. We'll probably start the last unit before Christmas. So this is 4 out of your number 5 unit, 5 units that we have to do. So this is all about energy. So let's start, let's just think about, first let's think about what work is, all right? So what is work? How do I know when I'm working? Okay, take a minute, talk to the person beside you. What is work? What do you think work is? So how do we know when we're working? Well, you know, if we think about it, say literally with with our biology, if we're working, say we're doing bicep curls or something, we're transferring chemical energy from inside of our muscles, inside of our cells, and putting it toward mechanical energy. Okay? So that's transferring energy inside my cells to a movement. So really we can break down work and just say that really it's a transfer of energy. Now, this can be kind of a hard thing to conceptualize because energy can be so, there can be so many different types of energy, and when they transfer or energy's converted, okay? So conversion or transfer of energy. When things are converted or transferred, when that energy is converted or transferred, according to our laws of thermodynamics, not all of that energy can be transferred. Some of it is lost, usually to thermal energy, friction, things like that. So let's talk about what kind of different energy there is. So let's say here's an example. So I go to Powder King, okay, that's be a good time, to go snowboarding. So from the time that, say, I'm on a chairlift, the chair takes me to the top of the hill, I get off the chairlift, and then I snowboard down. Turn to your neighbor and try and think of at least 6 different types of energy transfers that are happening there for work to be done. How many energies can you, types of energy can you think of? So this is when I would ask you to give me some examples, but obviously I'm recording this without you. So I think of something like, okay, the chairlift has electrical energy, and it's transferring it to mechanical energy. There must be some sort of mechanical mechanism to move the actual chairlift. Okay, there's chemical energy in my muscles to move me. So there's chemical energy from cellular respiration. Once I'm at the top of the hill, there's gravitational potential energy. When I'm moving, when I'm snowboarding down the hill, that's kinetic energy. We could, and you might have thought of more than that. So that's great. There's lots of different types of energy happening when we just do all of our different tasks. So in this unit, we are going to look at like elastic potential energy, kinetic energy, gravitational potential energy. And mechanical energy, how efficient something is when we're converting. So anyway, so what we're going to do, obviously, is we're going to start with work. Because really, work is the transfer of energy. So let's define work. So work, the definition is when a force acts upon an object to cause the displacement of the object, work is being done. So now, normally, like in Science 10, if you remember, work, we just said, work equals force times distance. Okay? But now, since we're going to study this a little bit more advancedly, we can say work equals force times distance times cos theta. Now, this isn't saying that what you did before was wrong. This is just advancing our understanding. And I'm going to show you some stuff that will help that. Now, take out your formula sheets. And so we've done all of kinematics. We've done dynamics. Well, we have one thing left in dynamics. But underneath, now we're on momentum and energy. So you should be able to find this one. Work is equal to force times distance times cos theta. Now, both force and distance are in your bar lines, right? So work equals force times distance times cos theta. So it doesn't matter if force and distance are positive or negative. But your cos theta is what's going to determine if work is being done in the direction of motion or against the direction of motion, etc. And I'll explain that. So, work... Oh, here. So, F is for force, and that's always in newtons. D is displacement in meters. Work is measured in joules. Okay? And theta is the angle between the force and displacement vectors. Work is also a scalar quantity. Any type of force has the ability to do work. The net work done on an object changes the velocity of the object because of the net force acting on it. So, in order for work to be done, the force in question needs to cause the displacement of the object. So consider the three different situations that I'm going to propose to you now. So, number one, let's say I have a box, and the box is going to be moving this way, to the right, and my force is exerted in the same direction of motion. So it's like I'm pushing a box, and so the motion is going in the direction of my force. So in this instant, these two vectors are parallel. So let's write that out. So vectors are parallel. Therefore, theta is between vectors. Therefore, theta between vectors is 0 degrees. Okay. So both of these are in the same direction. So it's like my force and my distance are like parallel. So there's no it's just zero. So then we would say for this cos of 0 degrees is equal to 1. Therefore, work equals force times distance because work equals force times distance times cos theta. If cos theta is 1, I can just eliminate that, so I have just work equals force times distance. So for when the force is in the same direction of the motion, work equals force times distance. And we can say now, because force is causing displacement, okay, number two. Let's say there's an object moving, but say it's moving this way, to the left. So the motion is this way. So an object is moving, okay, it's moving, and I want it to stop. Okay? So if it's moving that way, which way is the force going to have to go to stop it? To stop it, the force is going to have to go in the opposite direction. Just like, remember, back to our kinetics, if something was decelerating, the vectors had to be opposite, okay? So my force is opposite of my motion. So here, my vectors are at, maybe I'll just do this so you can see things clearly, are at an angle of theta equals 180 degrees. Because force is 180 degrees from the motion. So if I plug that in, post 180 degrees, that's equal to negative 1. So therefore, work is equal to negative force times distance. Because if it's negative 1, I can just say negative. Okay. So this is an example of a negative work, because force is hindering displacement. So that's why it's a negative work. So it's doing the opposite of what the motion is. So this is like trying to slow something down, stop something, push it. Basically, it's a push or pull in the opposite direction. Okay. Now, what if something has a motion, but the force isn't pushing it that way or that way, so we just have the force of gravity pulling down. So here, the angle between vectors is theta equals 90 degrees. So cos of 90 degrees is equal to 0. Therefore, no work is being done. If it's just, it's like a puck just sliding along the ice, but no one's pushing it or stopping it. So no work is being done on that puck because all the force is just the force of gravity, or Fn. And Fn. So the force is being done due to force. Now, your textbook goes into more detail about this. So open up your textbooks to page 292. So I want you to take a minute, a couple minutes, read page 292 to 293. Yes. And I thought that there was another one here. No. Yeah. So just read 292 to 293. So take the time now and do that, and then start the next video.